when you don't have a building, you're constantly looking for space. I've been pastor here from the very beginning, was the developing pastor. We moved here the Friday after Thanksgiving in 1995, started knocking on doors in January, had our first worship service at the end of March, and before that time, I think I'd maybe hit about 5,000 or 6,000 doors. The church office was in our home, in our basement, so on Wednesday nights, choir would be rehearsing upstairs in our living room and dining room, while downstairs in our basement, we had 20 kids in our confirmation class. And that worked. You couldn't do that forever, though. You could not grow a congregation forever in somebody's home. It really came to the point where you needed a building if the ministry was going to be able to continue or expand. We bought the land out here, swallowed hard when we did it, and we were a small group of folks. And so for the Mission Investment Fund to be able to provide us the money that allowed us to build the building, you know, really helped our growth. Banks will not touch congregations with a 10-foot pole, and especially new congregations.
Coming out of the business world, before I retired, my normal inclination was, let's go to a bank. And it surprised me a little bit, but it was just about impossible to even to talk to a bank.
If it were not for the Mission Investment Fund, there would be no Lord of the Hills Church here today. It is absolutely marvelous to be able to look back on those 15 years and to see how God has blessed us over this time. We've been fortunate over the years to establish a number of different missions and ministries.
We got involved with Habitat for Humanity. We got involved with the ministry in Tanzania and Pakistan and the Congo.
That just totally amazes me that this congregation on the fringes of the Denver metro area has been able to make these connections over the years. And that's because of the ministry that our buildings have been able to provide for us.
It's beautiful and it's wonderful. To see the kids on Sunday morning, you know, just laughter, smiling, singing, praising God. It's wonderful.